All right, guys, so I had another question. Is it okay to do yogurt on a ketogenic diet? Okay, well, it really depends. The problem with most yogurt is the sugar content is way too high. Even with kefir, it's way too high. Unless you can find something like this, Peak Triple Cream Plain Yogurt. It's a great company. And you also have to be careful about dairy in general, especially if it's non-organic, non-grass-fed, because there are a lot of hormones. So if you have a prostate problem, for example, that could create a problem with that, or you're susceptible to breast cancer, you're estrogen dominant, you don't want to be adding a lot of hormones. So if you're going to do dairy, whether it's cheese or yogurt or half and half or whole cream or sour cream or cream cheese, make sure it's a grass-fed, organic, very important. I don't recommend milk, has a lot of sugar, and it's actually just pasteurized. These other products are more fermented, and so they actually give some additional benefit. Now, you're gonna probably need some type of device like this one, the Labelli, which is awesome because you plug it in and it has these settings on here that bring the temperature down to 100 degrees. Most yogurt is made with higher heats, and it's a lot quicker. So this is gonna be 24 hours with the temperature of 100 degrees. And so you place these little ceramic things inside, and you can see that I just made some coconut yogurt. You can do almond yogurt. You can make yogurt out of goat's milk. Raw milk is best if you could find it, if it's not illegal in your state, or raw goat's milk yogurt, that's even better. So the real cool thing about the 24-hour yogurt process under low heats is you get a lot more microbes. You're talking like 700 billion CFUs. That stands for colony formation units, okay? Versus regular yogurt that only has like 1 to 5 billion CFUs. So that's quite a bit more because there's gonna be hardly any lactose at the end of this process. So it's gonna be kind of sour, which I like, and not sweet at all, but we don't want sugar in the yogurt. So it's a perfect product. It has the calcium, it has the B vitamins, it has the protein and the fat, okay? It's awesome. Now, if you're sensitive to dairy and you want a good probiotic, I highly recommend doing like kimchi or sauerkraut because those products are fermented vegetables and they not only give you the probiotic, but the prebiotic fibers that feed the microbes. So again, if you're gonna do yogurt, it has to be low sugar. You're gonna have to make your own. I put some links down below of how to do that. And thanks for watching, and definitely let me know what you think in the comment section below. Hey, before you go, I'm gonna create some new videos on food evaluation, okay? So if you'd like to participate, I can't promise that you'll be the person that I'll choose. So here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna take a picture of what you're eating, a close-up, okay, of one day, how frequent you're eating, like as an intermittent fasting, is it one meal, two meals, and anything else that you're drinking or supplements, and go ahead and add your height, weight, and age, and any major body problems that you're having. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna analyze that to see what you're doing correct and what you need to improve, all right? So go ahead and click the link down below, upload your information. And again, I can't promise that I'm gonna pick you, but I'm gonna pick several people and I'll do the evaluations and I'll post these as YouTube videos. All right, talk to you later.